Hey everyone, this is a response video to Shunyamurti. I don't know if he is going to watch this, but it's very important because he talks about a lot of things that a lot of spiritual teachers do, especially in this generation, which are great. But it also misses the point on how to develop and evolve. So the first thing that I want to point out is he says what we have to do is make sure that we don't need to have defenses against the internal chaos, so that we can eliminate the ego itself. So there's a couple things going on here. There's a fight against chaos. There's a fight. There's an acceptance that there is chaos, and that's bad. And there's also a belief that you have to eliminate the ego. So Shunyamurti is actually in stage coral, and we'll discuss that in the next minute. So the next thing is that Shunyamurti doesn't want. He doesn't want incoherence, but in stage Arbor Game, what do you like? You like incoherence because you don't see incoherence anywhere. When someone does something, you say to yourself, when someone says something, you're like, oh, okay, I see where that fits into this model. And this is not yellow. This is the overmind of Arbor Game. In stage yellow, you were narrow. It's like that's not true. You'll integrate their ideas, but you won't do it with a fluent ability, and you won't actually know what to do to create to make truth out of that. It'll take a lot of time. You'll have to say it's not true, and just say we have to throw out your opinion. Whereas in stage Aubergine, you're like it's all true and it's easy. I can fit that anywhere and make sense out of anything. So stage Aubergine actually doesn't mind incoherence, so you know that he's not in stage Aubergine. Okay, so yoga is, and the next thing he said was yoga is not identifying with the character in the dream. Basically, this is a staged turquoise epiphany. There's this spiral king, okay? And in the camera, spiral king is not who I am. That's why I call myself spiral king, because it's funny. I do believe I'm smart at spiral dynamics, but it's funny. So, daringly bold. So, therefore, it's I'm not identifying that as my persona, but that was turquoise, and the reason why I value it is because of lower rung stuff, or because it's just what we do on Earth. It's not something you're attached to. It's something that you consciously know helps you survive. So he's fixated on the turquoise way of doing things. But he also teaches with a stage coral lens of being proactive. You need to fight against something, whether it's the ego, whether it's systems, whether it's a way of thinking. There is something that we need to fight against. And he's trying to grasp the nature of clear. So he actually has a very good understanding of what clear is, because he clearly activated the higher rungs, the highest of rungs. So that's why he's so coherent. But at the same time, it seems that the reason why he developed a belief system that you got to be wary of the end of times and stuff, not only because he had mystical experiences, which he probably did, and that correlates to the unconscious, but besides for that, the reason why he does that is because when he was younger, he had an approach to life that he always got to be careful. And that is what's centering him in coral. But fails to grasp clear fully with the balance of. Oh, but he retains the balance of healthy teal in an organization format. So, stage teal will appreciate organization when they have it. So, if you're not a part of organization, but you're in stage teal, you won't really notice their belief systems. But he does demonstrate that he likes things to be integrous. So, integrity is a stage teal thing. For me, I did not promote integrity because I stayed in coral a long time and I adopted their value structure, their V-meme, with when I entered the V-meme of teal. But what I did do is I started to appreciate it over time. Also, remember, I had stage blue integrity for so long that I no longer need it as strongly in my later tiers, in my later stages. So he does demonstrate coral and teal, but not aubergine. And he also demonstrates turquoise. So what's the most likely thing is he's about 30% in coral, 30% in 30% in teal and 30% in turquoise. That's the most likely, and then everything else is probably scattered. But he clearly has clear active, and that's what makes it confusing. So you have to adopt a non-linear approach to it. Also, the way the supermind works, the supermind is something you're always tapping into, and clearly he's always tapping into it. So he's woke, not only woke, but he's very woke. So therefore, it's reasonable to say you got to lower each one down to like 25, 25, 25, and he's probably accessing like 30, 25, 75, like 20% clear. So, be aware that he's a lot smarter and intuitive than what I'm saying. And saying someone is in tier three is a very big compliment. So don't get me wrong. The next thing he mentioned is that we can't, but by saying you can't help the ego, you can't feed into its fantasies and all that. What that does is it creates a backlash. So he doesn't understand what 99% of spiritual teachers don't understand. You actually have to help the ego feel good, get those needs met so you can ascend. Because Shunyamurti is very teal-like, very he's an adult, he wants things to be proper and organized. That's stage blue, is a very adult-like. So they do things in a very organized way. But then you fail at seeing that maybe certain things are necessary at certain times. So there that's why there's positives and negatives to various stages of the rungs. And obviously the person demonstrates why there's beauty in all kinds of stages, because there's something you can learn from and benefit from the color and flavor that exists wherever you look. So yeah, that's my response to a specific video. I'll put the video that I'm responding to in the description. Take care.